Good day. So how should you invest $1 million? You just inherited, you sold a business, perhaps you've built it over time. Regardless, you now have $1 million and you're wondering, how should you invest $1 million? I'm Rob Tatro from robtatro.com, head of the Tatro Wealth Advisory Group here at Canaccord Genuity Wealth Management. And today we are talking about investing $1 million. Please make sure to subscribe. We'd love for you to join. We put out some great content. We'd love for you to subscribe to our videos and make sure to comment. If you got something you'd like to add, we'd love to hear from you. So let's take a look at a couple different case studies. So maybe you're young. You're in your 20s or 30s. You're in your late 20s and you just inherited $1 million. This is all non-registered after-tax money. How should you invest that $1 million? The first question I would ask you is, let's figure out your investment horizon. Let's figure out your risk tolerance. You know, if you're late 20s, your $1 million, you're probably not retiring. Or maybe if you are retiring, you'll really need to factor in that income stream for life is only expected to be about $50,000 according to the CFP Planning Institute. They like to use kind of 4 to 5% as an income stream in perpetuity on a dollar figure such as that. So you're getting that income. If you're still going to be working, then we're factoring in a long-term investment horizon. Let's make sure that we know your risk tolerance. Let's make sure we realize how comfortable are you having this portfolio, and then we'll build your portfolio around that. But you should likely own, could potentially own, you know, some Canadian dividend paying stocks, which are tax efficient. You could own some US companies, maybe some growth stocks in there, a few global companies as well. You should definitely own some tax efficient investments because this is going to be taxable income for you. So if you continue to earn your income, this is going to be taxable income. So we want to focus on any investment streams that pay either a return of capital or that convert convert something to a capital gain, such as real estate investment trusts or private REITs, anything infrastructure-wise. So dividends and return of capital are very, very good when it comes to that portfolio. So now you're working, you got your $1 million, it's going to be tax efficient, and over time you're expecting to get that growth. And the idea is that when you do reach that number that you're comfortable with, whether it's $2 million or $3 million or $4 million, then you actually can decide if you want to stop working and focus on other things. Maybe you're kind of in your late 40s, early 50s, and you either sold a business and now you got $1 million. You sold your business, you got $1 million. Now you're deciding what to do. So you've got your $1 million. You're still not quite comfortable enough to retire, right? So you definitely have to factor in, now what am I going to do with this money? Well, you should take a look at your RSP contribution rooms, your TFSA contribution rooms. Do you have kids? Do you want to max out the RESP for the education savings grant? That chunk, you will want to maximize every grant you can get from the government, every tax efficient pot of money that you can invest in, and every dollar that you can get back in the form of a contribution to an RSP. So those three things you definitely want to consider. You want to make sure you factor those in, maximize them, and to continue to build on that over time. Now, if you're in the same situation as the late 20-year-old where you're still working, you're going to have to factor in the tax consequences as well. If you've accumulated a bunch of wealth and this new $1 million is going to be added to your pot for retirement, well, then we can look at some holistic planning, and maybe now you got $2-3 million, and maybe now you can actually pull the plug and retire early, or maybe you can start traveling, maybe you can slow down at work. Those are all factors to consider, and you must take into account your investment horizon in that case. Finally, let's take a look at a retiree, someone who's maybe received his pension through a lump sum. Maybe it's a $1 million pension that he received through a defined contribution pension that's been converted to a LIRA. Or perhaps it's an inheritance, or maybe even a sale of farmland or something like that. Regardless, you're a retiree, you got your $1 million. Now it's very important, one, to structure a portfolio that will generate tax-efficient income for you now in retirement. So we will need to make sure that we're looking at all the investment opportunities that are paying consistent cash flow, whether it's private debt, whether it's private equity through real estate holdings, maybe it's some nice bonds, maybe it's some preferred shares that pay a dividend tax credit. Regardless, you'll want to make sure that you have tax-efficient income that's being generated now, because you will be drawing on that income. The key for you is also to be some tax planning, and that's something that we can help you with, and some financial planning. Remember, there's a lot of things that we talked about here today. I am an investment professional. I'm an award-winning portfolio manager, number 2 on the Wealth Professional 2018 list of top 50 advisors in the entire country. I am not an accountant. So please make sure to talk to your accountant when it comes to this and any other scenarios. Hopefully we covered some basics for you here today that'll help you and identify how to invest that $1 million if and when you do get it. And please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. make sure. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for tuning in. Have a great day.